Engineers make major contribution to human health, happiness, and way of life. The services for persons with disability on board airplane are very, very limited. This project started by looking at what will make boarding and onboarding of individuals with disability a little bit easier. We modify the airplane seats to be wheelchairs. They go out, they pick up the individual with disability, bring it to the cabin, get secured in place for the duration, meeting all regulations, and the individual travels with dignity and just like other passengers.
My research is at the intersection of computer science, electrical engineering, and medicine. At the moment, there is no way to reliably predict the survival outcome for the cardiac arrest patients. The good hospitals, they collect a huge amount of data from the patients. We have developed a method which automatically looks at the patterns inside the brain waves and also different types of data, which can be indicator of the survival outcome. The method that we have developed has a good accuracy of above 95%. The fact that my research can help improve patients' lives, especially those who are suffering from very complicated neurological disorders, is tremendously fulfilling for me.
So I'm actually an aerospace engineer. So I say my research is taking ideas from outer space and putting them back into inner space. So I use engineering techniques like fluid dynamics, material science, and I apply them to kind of figure out and understand some of the most deadly diseases in the world. So for example, one of my research projects is designing a cardiovascular heart patch with nanomaterials. So think about a Band-Aid for somebody that has had a heart attack and you want to regenerate that tissue. It's one of the very few tissues that once it dies, it doesn't regenerate. Because of this, most people who have had a heart attack will have another reoccurring heart attack after the past 2 or 3 years. A couple of researchers and I came up with an idea called a cardiovascular patch. So from an engineering perspective, I'm building this Band-Aid, what we call a scaffold, to kind of embed stem cells so that we can create an area that will be protected so those stem cells can regenerate that tissue over that dead tissue.
My research is at the intersection of robotics and biomechanics. Our main objective is to enhance human health. So robotics and manipulators are simply tools that we use to be able to enhance the quality of life, to help humans for daily activities. This robot is intended to be used for patients that have some neuromusculoskeletal disorders like Parkinson's disease or even cerebral palsy. So it's a torque controlled or position controlled. So you can use perception or different sensing information to control the robot. Or we have haptic devices in our lab. So haptics by definition means the sense of touch. So it's kind of a joystick, a remote controller. So you can connect it to Jayco arm and you can remotely teleoperate the structure. Hopefully in a couple of years, we can use it in hospitals to help patients.